Behold, the modern bra. But where did it come from? Meet Mary Phelps Jacob, born in 1891 in New York. Mary was born into a well-established New England family, and as a child, she attended school for dance and horse riding. With favorable marriage prospects ahead of her, Mary looked set to join the ranks of the American aristocracy. But in 1910, Mary bought a sheer gown for a party and found that her whalebone corset poked out of the gown and pushed under the sheer fabric. Nowadays, most people would ask, why should we wear a whalebone corset anyway? But back then, it was the only socially acceptable undergarment. If a corset won't work, she thought, why not make something else entirely? Mary called on her maid for assistance. With the help of some handkerchiefs, ribbon, and cord, they built the first modern upper undergarment for women, the brassiere. Here's how it works. Mary took two silk handkerchiefs and tied them together, using the ribbon and cord to frame the structure of the bra. The bra was secured through the use of straps. Mary Jacob wasn't the first person to invent a replacement for the hated whalebone corset. That honor goes to Mary Tusek, who created a precursor to the modern bra in 1893. However, Mary Jacob's design became the most widespread and easily available bra. When Jacob revealed her design to her family and friends, they asked her to make bras for them as well. She set up a business to sell the undergarment, but eventually grew tired of the business world and sold her design to the Warner Brothers Corset Company. Decades later, the bra has become one of the most popular undergarments on the globe,